Wait a minute.
Listen, that's what you need to do. Listen, a woman need to get in her place and listen. Read.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Esau have I hated. 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
And the head of the woman is the man. And the head of Christ is God.
So the scripture says you got God, Christ, man, woman.
That's right.
If you don't believe that, you out of order.
Unto your husband.
Read what the scripture says.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husbands.
Not me.
As unto
say, can I say, should she be a pastor?
I can't do it. No other man come before him, so don't no man run nothing.
So the husband is the head of the wife.
You understand that, bro?
And it also said when you.
The men, not the boys, the heavens have passed away with a great noise. The 2 Peter 3 and 10, God know he coming back. Tell a friend to repent, oh he gone with the wind. Free smoke, and that is thus said the Lord. I caught a murder that he wrote, just like Noah on a boat. Matthew 24, verse 36 on down. The hour nobody knows, like a thief in the night. When the Christ coming back here, life switching with the Father won't. That's my business, when we keep it low, that's righteousness. Yeah, you got a pass test. My people scattered abroad, from the east to the west.
Listen to this. Do you understand that you're a slave, bro?
Do I understand that I'm a slave?
Right now you're a slave.
Nah, I wasn't never a slave.
Read this.
I was born in America.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 48.
America's the one that enslaved you.
I wasn't never a slave.
Therefore, thou shalt thy serve thine enemy.
Brother, I want you to listen to this real good. I'm going to show you that you're still a slave. I'm going to show you all y'all. Read.
Therefore, thou shalt serve thine enemies.
So the God said you're going to serve your enemy. Keep that in your mind. Let me show you. Read.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
The Lord sent your enemy against you. Read.
In hunger.
Bro, when you want something to eat, where you go get it from?
My kitchen
or
food.
When you want something to eat, where you go get it from?
The stove.
Who owned the stove?
Bring it out.
I'm black.
Who own the stove? Where do they get their food from?
Companies.
Who own the companies?
Could be black. Who knows?
We know they don't own them, bro.
Do you know?
What? Okay. Who you know? That own a stove. They get their own produce. Who you know? Read.
In hunger and in thirst.
Let me ask you a question, sis. It said in thirst. Sister. Hey, sister. It said in thirst. Who you pay your water bill to, sister?
So who owns
that, sis? Come on, listen. Ain't no running from it. We know who owns all these things. Read it again.
Right.
In hunger.
Huh?
And in thirst.
So at the beginning of the scripture say you're gonna serve your enemies for hunger. So you want food? You go to the so-called white man. You want something to drink? You pay your water. Hey, matter of fact, sister, you got a cup in your hand. Where you get that cup from? What's the name on that cup? No, I want to know the name on it. What is the name on that cup?
Minimum.
Who on Minimum? Be truthful with yourself. You can lie to me, but be truthful with yourself. You know who owned it. Read.
In thirst.
Read.
And in nakedness.
Uh-oh. Everybody got on clothes out here, ain't it? Everybody got on clothes. Where did you get your clothes from, bro? Where you get your clothes from? No. Don't run. Where did you get your clothes from?
Anywhere.
Where you get your clothes from? The store. Who owns the store? Walmart? The black people own Walmart? Come on, be real with me. No, we don't. We go to our enemies for these things. Read.
And in one of all things.
Anybody out here got a driver's license? Where you get your driver's license from?
The DMV.
Who own the DMV?
Who knows?
Come on. You ain't know who knows. Come on. We can't be ignorant to these facts, bro. We can't be ignorant. The government. Who runs the government, sister?
Can I ask a question? Can I ask
Who said, I want you to say it loud.
Can I ask a question?
Who runs the government?
Can I ask a question?
Who runs the government?
It's a choice.
Who runs the government?
Whoever we put in there.
Hey, let me ask you a question. Let me ask you a question, sis. Let me ask you a question. If somebody, God forbid, somebody died in our family, we have to get a thing before we bury our dead. What is it called? No. What is it called? What we have to get when somebody died? What do we have to get? You can't answer the question. Don't run from it. We have to give a death certificate before we can bury that. Where do I get that death certificate from? Where I get that death certificate from? You bury somebody, don't get no death certificate. Matter of fact, you got some keys in your hand. Where you get your car from?
I don't have a car.
She got keys in her hand. Where did your car from?
Where I get it from?
Yes.
A locksmith.
Right.
She got it from a locksmith.
I ain't talking about the keys. I'm talking about a car. What, she got a car from a locksmith? Come on, bro.
She got a car from a car lot.
Come on. Who owned the car lot?
Matter of fact,
do all y'all live in these apartments? Right? Who live in these apartments? Raise your hand. Who do you have to go to get these apartments?
A black man.
Okay, now who does he report to?
A black man.
So he own them?
Yeah.
He own these apartments. A black man. What's his name? No. I need to know the black man name that own these apartments. Because I think you're lying.
I think you're lying.
I know you're lying.
It's the government.
I know you. Who own the government, sis? No, we don't. See, hey, matter of fact, if we own the governments, these will be your places.
One question.
We must come back and keep God's law. That's the whole point.
One question.
Who is this, sis?
It's your God.
Is this your God?
No.
Well, what's your God look like?
So
nobody know what God looks like.
What you say?
Do you get that out the Bible? Can we read it out the Bible what God looks like? King James. Show it to him. So we're gonna show you what God looks like. So we're gonna show you what God looks like, right? Have you read the Bible? Wait a minute. What scripture is that? Let's show you what God looks like. I want you to give me 1 John.
Josiah, back up.
I want you to give me 1 John 5 and 10. Let's see. Let's find out. 1 John and 5 and 10. Hey, let's listen. Let's read 1 John 5 and 10.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5. The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 10.
Y'all listen to this. Who look like a devil? Who look like a devil? Why?
Why?
Okay. I want y'all to just listen.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 10. He that believeth on the Son of God.
So he that believeth on the Son of God, read.
Hath a witness in himself.
Got a witness in himself. If you believe on the Son of God, read.
He that believeth not, God hath made him a liar. Because he believeth not the record that God hath given his Son.
So it said, if you don't believe in Christ, you don't believe the record. Go to Revelation 1. You don't believe the record which God has given of his Son. Let me show you something. Revelation 1 and 14. Let's see.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So the scriptures say his head and his hairs were white like wool. No, listen, read.
His head and his hairs was white like wool, as white as snow.
So this man is out. That man got hair like wool. Y'all understand that? Real simple. Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Hey, he said his eyes was a flame of fire. Wait a minute. Let's read out the scripture, not what we think. Read it again.
As white as snow. And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So the scripture said his eyes as a flame of fire. Read.
And his feet was like unto fine brass.
It said his feet
like unto fine brass. Sister, hold on. I'm looking at your feet, right? Say it again.
Yeah.
Right. That's right, sister. That's all we said. That's all we said. That's all we said. We going off what the Bible say, not what somebody told us in slavery. Listen, sis. That's what we doing.
YouTube.
Why? It's in the Bible, ain't it?
We got thousands of videos.
Oh, wait a minute. So, give me 1 John 4. What is it, 1 John 4:3? 1 John 4:3.
What's y'all YouTube now? Let me go on YouTube.
Huh? What it say? Say from what? Your enemy? Luke chapter 1 verse 68. Luke chapter 1 verse 68. Luke chapter 1. Wait, I want to tell you what. Show it to me in the Bible. Show it to me in the Bible. Or did somebody tell you that? Somebody told you that? Let's read this.
The book of Luke, chapter 1 and verse 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel. The God of Israel. Nobody else. The God of Israel. Read.
For he had visited and redeemed his people.
Anybody that know English, his people is a possessive pronoun. His people. Read.
Verse 69. And he hath raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David. He, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which has been since the world began.
What did he come for?
For he has saved his people.
He has saved what? Oh, wait a minute. Keep reading.
Book verse 71. That we should be saved from our enemy.
That we should be saved from our enemies. Enemies.
He ain't necessarily.
Why they ain't out here trying to keep him safe?
Man, you could be free.
Give me Genesis 25:25. Give me Genesis 25:25. You love the white man, don't you? You love the white man, don't you? Yeah, yes, you do. Right. Right. Let's see what the Bible says.
The book of Genesis, chapter 25 and verse 25. And the first came out red.
So the first came out red.
We really the region of Israel.
All over like a hairy garment.
Now, what do we call these people today?
But you can't do like that.
What's the red people today? What do we call them? What do they call themselves?
Can't focus on just our
when you slap something, what?
He said Jews and Gentiles.
Rednecks.
We can break
so
it down.
So, read it again.
Verse 25. And the first came out red. All over like a hairy garment.
Y'all going to run away.
And they called his name Esau.
They called his name Esau. Let me give you, Romans 9:13. Because, hey, let me ask you a question, sis. You doing a lot of talking. Let me ask you a question. Does God love everybody? Does God love everybody?
Yes, he does.
Can we read out the scripture? Give it in. Hold on. No, don't leave. Don't run.
The book of Romans, chapter 9 and verse 13.
Listen. That's what you need to do. Listen. A woman need to get in her place and listen. Read.
Whoa.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Esau have I hated. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. 1 Corinthians chapter 11. See, that's the problem. That's why we're in captivity now. The sisters don't want to humble down.
Wait a minute.
See, read.
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 3. But I have you to know that the head of every man is Christ.
The head of every man is Christ.
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of the woman is the man.
That's right.
Read it again.
Verse 3. But I will have you to know that the head of every man is Christ.
So the head of every man is Christ. Christ is the head of every man. This is what the Bible is saying. Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
The head of the woman, guess who he is? Who the head of the woman, brother? Who the head of the woman? Oh, you didn't. Let's read the Bible. The Bible gonna tell us who the head of the woman is. Who the head of the woman?
And the head of the woman is the man. And the head of Christ is God.
So the scripture says you got God, Christ, man, woman.
That's right.
If you don't believe that, you out of order. You out of order. Read it again. Hold on. Give me Ephesians chapter 5. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 23. That's what I want off. Ephesians 5, 23, 22. Let's read this. Let's read what the scripture says. You women going to have to humble down. Yes, ma'am. Okay, so yes, ma'am.
If the woman is supposed to sit
submissive.
down,
submissive.
Right, right.
How submissive was Mary when she carried the word?
She carried the word.
Carried
what scripture says she carried the word? Talking about Jesus. So did Jesus have a daddy?
No.
He had no daddy?
No, he didn't have a human daddy.
You sure?
He had the
give me John chapter 1 verse 42.
Say,
now, hold on. No. Don't run.
Jesus
don't run.
Have a daddy.
Don't run.
God. Oh,
okay.
Jesus.
Okay, you believe
Mary.
You believe the Bible?
Mary was a virgin.
You believe the Bible?
I believe in the Bible.
Let's read what the Bible say then. Let's read what the Bible say. Because, see, you've been going up to that church with Pastor Pope Chop, eating them pork chops all the time, hooping and hollering, they gave you no scriptures.
Right.
We're going to give you the scriptures, bro.
That's right.
Read this. John chapter 1. Hold on, I'm going to show you, bro.
Read it.
Read it.
Verse 45.
Thank you.
Verse 45. Philip finding Nathanael and saith unto him, we have found him of whom Moses in the law and in the prophets did write. Jesus of Nazareth.
Jesus of Nazareth.
The son of Joseph.
The son of who?
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 The son of Joseph.
Give me Ephesians 5:22. Ephesians 5:22. So this is what I'm seeing. We keep reading out the scriptures. We keep reading the scriptures. Y'all don't want to accept the scriptures. Y'all don't want to accept the scriptures. I'm going to read this. Read that.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 5, and verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband.
What it say? What the scripture say?
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband.
Read what the scripture say.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband.
Not me.
As unto the Lord.
So submit yourself unto your husband as unto the Lord. Read.
For the husband is the head of the wife.
The husband is the head of the wife.
That's
hard, angels. That's hard. Oh, that's too much on you to see. That's the scripture. All right. Come on, see.
My husband is the head. My husband is a woman.
No problem.
What you saying? That I'm listening to her.
So should a woman teach?
Yeah, she teaching me.
1 Timothy chapter 2. Let me show you something. Hey, hold on. Can I say, should she be a pastor? Over the whole congregation. So she's teaching women and men.
Yeah, she's all right,
let's see what the scriptures say. Let's see. Can I see what the scriptures say?
Okay.
And I'm going to read the scripture now. What's been happening here out here today is, we'll say something, or you guys will say something, and we'll say that's not in the scripture. Then I'll read the scripture, then you'll say, I ain't gonna follow that.
Can I ask you a question?
So what that means, let's read the script. Let's read the script, we'll say. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11.
King James Bible. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11.
Let's read this. Let's see what it says.
Let the woman learn in silence.
So what a woman supposed to be doing? What does the scripture say? What does the scripture say? Read.
With all subjection. But I suffer not a woman to teach.
Wait a minute. He said he suffer not, meaning he don't allow Labusa. Which one of them Jesus, man? Which one? Show him. Point him out. You see what I'm saying? Y'all understand how destroyed we are as a people?
Right.
This look just like you got hurt like wool, just
That's
like
right.
you, bro. You're a king on this earth. You
That's
understand
right.
that, bro?
Can I ask you a question?
Read.
Come on, boy.
Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection. But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor to usurp authority over the man.
I'm going to give you a biblical answer if you do, bro. Labusa. You're a king on this earth, bro. You understand that? You're a king on this earth.
Then if we were supposed to be here, why did Adam fall to eat and bite that apple?
Right, because he didn't stay in his place. Stay in his place. Read it again.
But I suffer not a woman to teach, nor usurp authority over the man, but be in silence. For Adam was the firstborn.
So Adam was the firstborn.
Bring it out.
Then Eve. So Adam was the firstborn.
Okay,
then Eve.
And Adam was not deceived.
Adam wasn't deceived. Adam was not tricked.
But the woman was deceived.
The woman was deceived.
Was in transgression.
The woman was deceived, bro. You a God on this earth, bro. Let me show you something, bro. Give me Psalms 82, man. Man, you're a God on this earth, bro. Woman is not God. Woman is not God. Man is the head of the house.
Even though God said he'll tell God to,
no other man come before him, so don't no man run nothing.
So wait a minute. So the man don't run the household. The man don't run the household.
He tells household.
So man don't run the household.
They run it.
Let's read what the scripture says. Give me 1 Corinthians 11 again, man. Give me 1 Corinthians chapter 11 again. Let's go over this again. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 3. Matter of fact, give me Genesis 18. Genesis 18. Genesis 3 and 16. Then we're going to go to Genesis 18. Genesis 3 and 16. Genesis 3 and 16. Listen to this. Listen to this.
The book of Genesis, chapter 3 and verse 16. Unto the woman, he said,
this is to the woman. This is talking about the women.
I will greatly multiply thy sorrow, thy conception. In sorrow thou shalt bring forth children.
The woman going to bring forth children in sorrow. Read.
And thy desire shall be unto your husband.
What he
gonna
do?
And he shall rule over thee.
And he shall what?
He shall rule over thee.
He shall what?
He shall rule over thee.
He shall what?
He shall rule over thee.
The scripture said the man is gonna rule over the woman. Listen. Did I say this or did the Bible say that?
No.
Did I say this or did the Bible say this? So let me show you something. If you don't like what the Bible is saying, give me 1 Thessalonians 4 and 8.
I love what the Bible says.
Well, if you love what the Bible says, hold on, I'm going to read this scripture. I'm going to read this scripture, then I'm going to let you talk, sis, okay? What's your name, by the way?
My name is Latrice.
Latrice, I'm Obadiah.
Okay, my name is Latrice.
I'm going to read this to you, Latrice. Read it.
The book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 and verse 8. He therefore that despiseth not man.
So if you despise his word, you don't despise man. Read.
I don't despise no man.
But God.
So you despising
amen.
God.
I'm going to stick to that. The only man that I protect over my household is my nine-year-old son.
Your nine-year-old son is over your household.
Amen. Can you hold it, reverie?
So you married?
You married?
Yes, I'm married.
And you telling me that your 9-year-old son is over your house? I got to look at the camera when I say that, because
yes.
I need this on tape.
Yes, it's on tape. Yes,
sis. So yes. Let's go back to the Ephesians 5:22. I want you to listen, because see, I do understand that men, us, we as the so-called black men, we are destroyed as a people. We very destroyed. We don't understand our place of where we are today. So now, in order for us to get back into our rightful place, we must come back and keep God's laws. You understand? You say you was married, right? Listen to this. Brother, I'm finna tell her something.
Whatever she say, go.
The book of Ephesians.
Whatever he say,
Listen to the scripture. Can we listen to the scripture?
The book of Ephesians,
chapter 5 and verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband.
Now, let's go. I didn't say that. So God got you messed up? God got you messed up? Brother, young brother, I want you to explain what the word submit means.
Submit.
What does the word submit mean?
That means give up all things to
her. That means to honor him as a husband. Because he's the head of house. Read. Hold up, brother. Read.
The book of Ephesians, chapter 5 and verse 22. Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband.
Listen.
As unto the Lord.
Okay. Wait a minute. I need y'all to get this.
God, forgive me.
Read this again.
Wives, submit yourselves.
Sis, I want you to listen to this. Just give me a minute. Listen. Because it's gonna give you a comparison, brother. Hold on. Let the sister listen.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband as unto the Lord.
The scriptures say, submit yourself unto the husband as unto the Lord. Just like you submit to the Lord, you submit to your husband.
That's right.
That's what the scriptures say.
Submit unto your husband.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband. As unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife.
Wait a minute. Maybe they didn't hear that. Read that again.
For the husband is the head of the wife.
Read it again so the young brother can hear it.
For the husband is the head of the wife.
You understand that, bro?
And also said when you get
you understand
married,
that, bro?
Come on.
Right.
Not two.
Let me ask you a question, bro. You've been going against the Bible all day. But I'm going to give you something that you can understand. I'm going to give you something you can understand.
You ever
watch football?
Jesus said.
You ever watch football?
But whatever you say.
You ever watch football, bro? Like you ever watch football?
I love football.
Right.
I love football.
So who is the head of the team?
The quarterback.
So let me show you this. I'm not worried about that. I'm making an example, bro.
Who
runs the football team? Who calls the shots? Who calls the shots?
Just as much a man can do.
Who called the shots? At the football game. The quarterback or the whole team. Simple question, y'all. Something that y'all can understand. I'm speaking corner things to you.
Does the quarterback call the shot?
Read it again.
Wives, submit yourselves unto your husband as unto the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ is the head of the church. And he is the Savior of the body.
So just like Christ is the head of church, the husband is the head of the household.
That's right.
Real simple, man. Real simple. Let me ask you a question, sis. Why do our sisters wear pants? Deuteronomy 22 and 5.
Bring it up.
Deuteronomy 22 and 5. My wife does work.
Okay, she ain't supposed to work. You're right.
What scripture? Show me a scripture that say that. Show me a scripture. Read that.
The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5.
Don't run, sis.
The woman.
The woman. It's talking about you, ain't it? Are you a woman?
Yeah.
You a woman? And you a woman. You fully grown. Fully grown. Read.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So the scriptures say, got you effed up, huh? I'll praise. Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
So neither shall a man put on, okay, go ahead. So a man shouldn't wear a dress and a woman shouldn't wear what?
Because God said that's a disgrace unto him, because that means
you're fat. All right. Hold on. Let's read the sister.
That's a disgrace.
Hey, 1 Corinthians 14:40.
That's why he said that.
I got you, sis. I need to read the scripture so they get the understanding, okay? 1 Corinthians 14:40. 1 Corinthians 14:4. Let's understand something. This is something that we don't all have. Y'all understand that? 1 Corinthians 14:40. We're going to read this.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 14 and verse 40.
Listen up.
Let all things be done decently and in order.
So the scripture said, "Let all things be done decently." Right. That meaning, when I'm talking, you gotta be shh.
No, you say.
Let us be the children of God. We are not black men. We are Israelites.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us, subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.